Hello everyone, welcome to the cloud network. In this tutorial I will show you how to create a new user account and how and set the password in a Windows Server 2003, and the same also thing you can do to Windows Server 2008. So let us begin now. So you can see this is my Windows Server 2008 R2 Enterprise Edition, which I have downloaded and installed. In my previous video I have shown you how to install Windows Server 2003. Now let us begin to create a new account. So just click on start. First of all I will show you how to make a full screen on this one. To make a full screen for this Windows Server, just right click and go to screen resolution, and you need to click on resolution. There you can see 1020, or you can select 1600 into 1200 also. Just apply it and click keep the changes. Okay, so you can see on the screen just now I put my screen full resolution. So this is my screen full resolution. Just we are just click. Let us begin offer to create a new account. Click on start and click to here administrative. You need to find computer management. So this is the computer management. There you can click on the computer management, and there is another option that you can create that you can come to this local management service. So just click on this one, startup. Let us go to scroll down and to click on start, and just right click on computers, go to manage. When you click on to go to manage, so scroll up, so there you can see to go to the service. This is server manager and this is a computer man. The same thing you can find there also, this is also. Okay, so we need to create a new user account. So here also is there, but you can create a new user account. Just right click and create a new account. So here is the thing that you can create a new account, and let us begin to create a new account. So I'm giving a name like cloud network. So my new user, okay, and the full name I will give cloud network. Okay, so now I'm going to set a password for this my login, and we need to set a strong password, and we need to send combine with the alphabetic and numerical and symbols. So we need to use every combines alphabets, small letters and capital letters with symbols we need to use to set this password. So you want to check account disabled, means it will be disabled for this user. User must change the password as next login. So I am going to password never expire. I'm going to check option and I'm going to click create. So this is the password I have, user, and I have been create. So you can see this is my user and I have been set a password. So the same thing here also you can create. Just go to this local, right click on user. The same thing you also find here also, and here also we can create a groups. I double click and then so just click on to groups, and then click to right click new groups. There you can name a group name like that. You can name as sales department, like that you can give any name, and then you need to click on add. Then you can give here cloud, and then check for purpose. Okay, then you can click OK. So click to add, already added. Okay, click to create now. So close this one. So you can see in the sales department the user has been added cloud. So this is the things that you can add groups in groups also with the department. You can add any number of users into the groups. So this is my user, and let us, if you want to reset the password, just click and proceed with this. If you want to set any password, give a like I am giving this password small character, three number of characters. When you click OK, you will get these types of error: the password does not meet policy requirement. For this condition, what you have to do is just you need to go to local settings, like click on start administrative full. You need to find security, local security policy. Click on this one, local security policy, and then you need to click on accounts, click to policy, and double click on to disable this one. Password must be complexity. Apply it. Okay. So this is one. If you want to limit the age length, and if you want to store the encrypted anything you want to do, is you can do it. And then what you have to do is go to cloud and then click proceed. This is see, and I'm giving three number of character password and click OK. So you can see it has been set a password. So this is the method to set a new to create a new user and set a password, and how to and that we create a new groups and added that user. So if you have any problem adding, or if you get any sort, if you have any question, you can comment below to my video. Thank you for watching my IT Cloud Net of videos. Please subscribe to IT Cloud Net.